Hello and welcome to the Grand Line Review, your source for everything One Piece. And today, for the Devil Fruit Encyclopedia, we have a very special edition, as we are finally going to examine one of the most popular, and quite possibly one of the best Devil Fruits in the series, with the Ope Ope no Mi. The Ope Ope no Mi is a Paramecia type fruit that allows its user access to a whole bunch of sheer craziness, primarily through the creation of a spherical space known as a room. And within said room, the user has complete control of the objects and beings caught inside of it. This allegedly makes the user a free modification human, and speaking of said user, this fruit is wielded in the series by none other than fan favorite Trafalgar Law, and it made its first appearance during the Sarpedi Archipelago arc. The fruit actually takes its name directly from the English word operation, which is a reference to the space the user creates, often being compared to a surgical operating room, which is also aided by the fact that Trafalgar Law is a doctor. But although despite being taken directly from an English word, both Viz and Funimation decided to change the name ever so slightly by knocking off the E sound to simply become the Op-Op fruit. All right, so let's start seriously diving into this by beginning with the concept of a room, because this is a necessary precursor to access any of the fruit's deeper benefits. Essentially, the user generates a transparent sphere, the size of which is at the behest of the wielder. In the series, it's quite common to see rooms that only span the diameter of a few meters. However, it has also been shown that the user can extend this to cover extraordinary spaces spanning entire mountains, and that may not even be the full extent of it. However, the bigger the room becomes, the significantly more difficult it is for the user to maintain the space, as it requires quite a bit of effort and stamina. And also quite notably, once a room is generated, it is entirely stationary until the user chooses to deactivate it. Now, why does all of this matter? Well, it's because once this room exists, the user of the Ope Ope no Mi is more or less allowed to play God in their tiny pocket dimension which they have created. To illustrate, a basic invocation of this power is seen in the amputate technique, whereby Law is able to use his sword to cut anyone or anything. However, as a result of being within the room, his victims are completely unharmed, despite having any number of body parts separated. In essence, the results are kind of like the Barabara no Mi, which allows the user to split their body into however many parts they desire, except the Ope Ope no Mi flips this on its head by allowing its user to split the bodies of others, provided they are within the room. However, this is really only the beginning, because once inside the room, the user can also perform an ability known as Shambles, which allows them to switch the placement of any objects or beings. So say for example, you craft a room that has you at one end and a happy little tree on the other, you would then be able to invoke Shambles to achieve a teleportation style effect, where you and the tree instantly swap places. But if we take this a step further and use Shambles in conjunction with Amputate, then the user of the Ope Ope no Mi would be able to say slice the head clean off an enemy and replace it with whatever else happens to be in the room at the time, which could be, I don't know, what do I see in my room right now? The complete all-in-one edition of Death Note. Yeah. That'll do. In addition, the user of the Ope Ope no Mi has complete control over anything and everything in the room through the use of Tact, an ability that allows them to levitate whatever they see fit with seemingly no restrictions. And to demonstrate that, in the series, Law has shown the ability to levitate an entire marine battleship, although it is entirely possible that the larger the object, the more strain the user suffers as a result. Now, these are still very much the basic applications of the Ope Ope no Mi, and a skilled user can take these powers to truly crazy places, but I feel like we can't go much further without mentioning that this fruit is actually referred to as the ultimate Devil Fruit, and it's because of its greatest ability known as the Perpetual Youth Surgery, or also known as the Perennial Youth Operation, or rather simply the Immortality Operation, depending on which translation you subscribe to. Whatever the case, the result is much the same, in that the user can perform this operation on another being in order to grant them eternal youth. Now, just to address this whole eternal youth thing, there is quite a bit of confusion amongst the fanbase about the exact nature of this ability, with many believing that it actually renders someone immortal. And you know, it's kind of hard to blame them, given that the Viz manga translation literally calls it the Immortality Operation, but Eternal Youth is a much more accurate description. What it will do is freeze someone's aging, kind of like the side effect of Sugar's Devil Fruit, the Hobby Hobby no Mi, but it will not prevent the user from dying in general, say from drowning or being shot in the head, or any other mechanism that usually results in death that isn't old age. But as a result, the Ope Ope no Mi carries a mind-boggling value within the One Piece world, as individuals are willing to pay as much as 5 billion berries for it. And to put that number into some perspective, there are Emperors of the Sea whose bounties are not even half that price. So this is pretty damn serious money. However, things aren't quite as simple as having someone consume the fruit and then getting them to bestow eternal youth upon you, as there are two highly restrictive conditions that come along with it. The first of which is that this ability can only be accessed by someone with extraordinary knowledge and brilliance, which probably implies that it could not be achieved by your run-of-the-mill doctor. So finding that candidate is going to be very difficult to begin with, and that's before we even get to the second condition, which is that to perform the operation, the user of the Ope Ope no Mi must sacrifice their own life. So yeah, good luck fulfilling those criteria on your quest for eternal youth. With that said, the user doesn't have to grant someone eternal youth to make fantastic medicinal use of the Ope Ope no Mi, and it has been stated in the series that a previous user of the fruit was able to perform numerous miraculous operations and was even able to cure all sorts of disease that no traditional medicinal or surgical procedures were capable of. With this in mind, it's even a popular idea amongst fans to attribute the Opiopinemi as the solution to Chopper's dream in the series to find a cure for all disease. And you know what? In the hands of a skilled medical practitioner, this fruit may just be that. However, it is highly impractical, to say the least, to administer its powers to the world at large, so I don't think this is quite the solution to Chopper's problem. But to further examine how a skilled professional can make use of the Opiopinemi, let us now turn to Trafalgar Law. To call him a fantastic devil fruit user would be an understatement, and having trained as a doctor prior to consuming it, he really is more or less the ideal candidate for this fruit. Everything I mentioned before, Law has found a way to escalate. For example, in terms of the basic amputate technique, Law has proved to be even capable of using it to dismiss opponents entirely clad in haki, a substance that generally nullifies devil fruit abilities. While working on a more micro scale, Law has also developed a cunning proficiency in removing the hearts of his opponents, which once again, as the result of the room, will not kill them, although should the heart be compromised, then yes, it will result in their death. And rather insanely, Law has even developed a more advanced version of Shambles, whereby he is seemingly able to spot the souls of various individuals and place them in other bodies, although this is visualized through the switching of cartoon-style hearts. Regardless, this is exceptionally powerful, and it was able to cripple the power of half of the Straw Hat crew simply by placing them in unfamiliar bodies. And of course, Law's medical knowledge comes into full force with techniques such as Countershock, in which Law releases a strong electrical surge smack bang into the chest of an opponent, kind of like a defibrillator, as well as his most powerful technique known as the Gamma Knife, in which Law crafts a small but deadly blade of energy designed to destroy an opponent's internal organs. Quite notably, this technique is said to be powerful enough to bring down figures such as Doflamingo, or well, it would have been, if not for his own devil fruit, which allowed him to perform some emergency repairs via the ever useful substance of string. Despite that, Law is quite likely to be a rare case in the series of a devil fruit user who was able to wield their power to its fullest potential. Now, speaking of the whole potential thing, speculating on what this fruit could do in its awakened form is a fairly maddening task. This fruit is already wildly powerful as it is, and one would assume that an awakening may grant further room abilities, such as being able to create or destroy matter rather than simply manipulate it, or perhaps even a concession to manipulate objects or people outside of the room in limited capacities, of course. But the thing I keep coming back to is the perpetual youth surgery. As the ultimate technique of the fruit, I can't help but think that another prerequisite would be to awaken the Opiopinemi. So perhaps an awakening of the fruit may allow the user to create a permanent room around or even within a certain individual that keeps their body in that sort of perpetually immune state, at the cost of the user's life, of course. Whatever the case, I feel fairly certain that this is one of the few fruits in the series for which the question of awakening will eventually be answered, because this whole eternal youth business has been flagged pretty heavily, so we need simply wait for where it will take us. Some other things to consider when becoming a free modification human. To add on to the numerous miscellaneous benefits of the fruit, whilst invoking the room, the user is also able to perform a scan of everything caught within it, essentially giving the user the necessary knowledge to have complete control over absolutely everything within the room, as there is no possible way to hide either yourself or any of your precious items from the scan. And also, up until now, I don't think we've quite stressed the negative aspects of this fruit anywhere near enough, but it does come with one pretty big issue, which is that every use of the fruit's abilities come at the cost of the user's stamina. And furthermore, a user overexerting themselves can even result in the direct reduction of their lifespan. But despite that one unfortunate weakness, it's pretty difficult to fault this fruit. When used proficiently, these abilities should make you practically invincible in combat. I say practically because it does depend on the caliber of your opponent, but for the most part, you're looking pretty fine. And while the full potential of the Opiopinemi can really only be reached with someone of advanced medical knowledge, that doesn't make it at all useless to the average being. All the basic techniques like amputate, shambles, and levitation would still be available. And honestly, if that was all the devil fruit had to offer, and I'd still think it was pretty amazing. But if you are a doctor, then this is an absolute must eat. There is arguably no better fruit out there for you, because even with everything I've mentioned during this video, there's still some odd little uses that I have left out, and a lot of room for further exploration with your particular expertise. But once again, if you're not a doctor, then just eat it anyway. It'll be good fun, I promise. And with that, we are going to commit the Opiopinemi to the Devil Fruit Encyclopedia. Next week, we will be moving on to another fantastic fruit, held by none other than Marine Admiral Kizaru with the Pika Pika no Mi. If you enjoyed this video and the content this channel produced in general, then please do consider donating to the Grand Line Review Patreon, because the support of all of you amazing people is what continues to make this channel possible. And if you'd like to see more videos like this but apply to other anime and manga series, then please do check out my second channel, New World Review, for all of your wider needs. And if you'd like to join the fun at any time, then please do head over to my Discord server, where a wide array of shenaniganry takes place on a daily basis. And finally, please do comment with your thoughts on the Opiopinemi no Mi. This has been the Grand Line Review, and I'll see you next time.